Hello friends, welcome back to Bee Pharma Wise. Today we are going to discuss Markovnikov's rule, its example and mechanism in very simple manner. And at the end of the video, I'll be presenting 5 MCQs based on Markovnikov's rule. So if you could answer those MCQs correctly, you can be sure that you have understood the concept really well. So watch the video carefully so that you can answer the questions at the end correctly. One more thing I wanted to share with you all. I was going through my analytics recently and I realized that 80% of my viewers have not subscribed to my channel. Guys, it is so heartbreaking. Please subscribe. Please hit that red button. It will cost you nothing, but it will mean a lot to me. So please subscribe the channel and also hit the notification bell so that you'll stay updated. And now without further ado, let's dive right into the video. So today's topic of discussion is Markovnikov's rule, and Markovnikov's rule is applicable to addition reactions. Now, addition reactions are the most important reactions exhibited by alkenes or alkynes. So first, let me take you through how these addition reactions occur in alkenes. I'll take an example. For example, this is the basic alkene skeleton, and in alkene skeleton there are two bonds, right? One of them is a sigma bond and one of them is a pi bond. As you know, pi bond is much weaker than a sigma bond, and it is also very loosely bound and away from the main carbon skeleton. It makes those electrons available for attack by an electrophile. So what happens when any electrophile which is generated through a reagent, see, suppose EnU is a reagent, it will give you an electrophile and a nucleophile. Okay, so what happens is this electrophile from the reagent will go and attack on these pi electrons. Now this arrow should be shown like this, from, because we always show the movement of electrons from the donor to the receiver. So this electrophile goes and attacks on the pi electron density. Now what happens? One of the carbon will form a bond with this electrophile using these two electrons. So what happens in the process of addition of electrophile to an alkene? This pi bond breaks. These two electrons will be utilized by this electrophile to form a bond with the carbon. Now what happens is, suppose this electrophile attaches to this carbon, this double bond has been broken, this carbon was having two bonds and additionally it formed a bond with electrophile. Now in this process, because of this pi bond is broken, this carbon becomes positive, electron deficient, and it gives rise to a carbonium ion. Now in the next step, the nucleophile in the medium will go and attack on this carbocation, this positively charged carbon, and then this nucleophile forms a bond with this carbon using the electron pair available with the nucleophile. And so what we get is C nucleophile C electrophile. So basically what is happening is one pi bond is broken, and instead of one pi bond, two new sigma bonds are formed between carbon and nucleophile and carbon and electrophile. Now as the entire mechanism is triggered by initial attack of an electrophile, such addition reactions of alkenes are referred as electrophilic addition reactions. So this is the mechanism by which addition reactions occur in alkenes. Now let's discuss one particular reaction where I'll be adding HBr as a reagent into, say, ethene as an alkene. So I'll take you through the reaction. C double bond C H H H H, it is nothing but ethene, and I'll be adding HBr as a reagent in the ethene. Now HBr will split as H plus and Br minus. So H plus will be our electrophile and Br minus will be our nucleophile. Okay, now what happens? This electrophile will go and attack on the electron density. So what will happen? One of the carbons will be having these two electrons from the pi bond, which it will utilize to form a bond with hydrogen. So what you will get is CHH, this single bond C, then HH as it is, and this H will be added. In this process, this carbon will become deficient in electrons, so carbocation is formed. Now this bromide ion will go and attack on the carbocation to give you CH2BrCH3. Okay, now in any case, suppose this pi bond was broken and electrons were retained by, say, this carbon, then your electrophile will go and attach to this carbon and that product will be obtained. Suppose in a different case, these electrons were retained by this carbon, then what will happen? This initial electrophile will go and attach with this carbon, and what you will get is CH3, then CH2, and now this carbon will become positive and Br will be attached to this. Okay, so what you will get? CH3CH2Br. Here what did you get? CH3CH2Br. So in any case, if you are dealing with a symmetrical alkene like ethene, the product obtained will be the same, identical. So this is the case where Markovnikov's rule doesn't come into picture. But if you are dealing with an alkene like propene, let me take an example, CH3CH double bond CH2. This is propene, this is the double bond. There is CH2 group at one side of double bond and CH-CH3 group at the other side. Such alkenes where there are different portions of alkyl moieties either side of the double bond, they are called as unsymmetrical alkenes. Now what happens? If you add unsymmetrical reagents like HBr to unsymmetrical alkenes, we will see what happens. HBr will be splitted as H plus and Br minus. Same electrophilic addition mechanism will be followed. So this H plus will go and attack on the pi bond. Now if the pi bond is taken up by this carbon, then hydrogen will go and attach with this carbon first. So what you will get is CH3CH. This carbon will be positive and the single bond CH3. Okay, this will be the first step. And in the next step, this bromide ion will attach here. And what you will get is CH3CHBrCH3. Okay, this is the one thing. Now what is possible is, suppose this electron pair is retained by this carbon, then this hydrogen will go and attach to this carbon. It is equally possible. So then in that case, what will happen is CH3, now this hydrogen will attach to this carbon. So you will get CH2, the single bond, then this CH2, and here this carbon will become positive. Are you getting it? Right. So then this bromide ion will come and attach to this part to give you CH3CH2CH2Br. So if you can see in the first reaction where H plus was attached to this carbon, terminal carbon, you landed up with 2-bromopropane. Okay, and when this H plus attached to this carbon, which is a secondary carbon, you ended up with 1-bromopropane. So it clearly indicates that when you are adding an unsymmetrical reagent to an unsymmetrical alkene, something different happens than your addition in a symmetrical alkene. Now here in this case, there are two possibilities. 2-bromopropane can be formed, 1-bromopropane can be formed. So which will be the major product? So experimentally, it has been confirmed that 2-bromopropane will be your major product. And how and why This can be explained on basis of Markovnikov's rule. So after studying a large number of addition reactions, the Russian chemist Vladimir Markovnikov came up with a fantastic rule which is applicable to addition of unsymmetrical atoms to an unsymmetrical alkene. And what does he say? He states that when an unsymmetrical reagent is added to an unsymmetrical alkene, positive part of the reagent, means your electrophile, will go and attach with carbon carrying greatest number of hydrogen atoms, double bonded carbon. Okay, so who is the double bonded carbon here? This and this. This carbon is having one hydrogen and this carbon is having two hydrogens. So this carbon is having greatest number of hydrogen atoms. So according to Markovnikov's rule, this positively charged electrophile will go and attach with the carbon, double bonded carbon containing greatest number of hydrogen atoms. And if it attaches here, this path will be followed and 2-bromopropane will be your major product. Okay, so this is what Markovnikov's rule is. I'll repeat the rule. Markovnikov's rule states that when an unsymmetrical reagent is added to an unsymmetrical alkene, positive part of the reagent will go and attach with a double bonded carbon carrying greater number of hydrogen atoms. So this is the Markovnikov's rule. Now let's discuss the mechanism of Markovnikov's rule. The mechanism of Markovnikov's rule can be explained well with the modern mechanistic theory. So we will take the same example of addition of HBr in propene. So CH3CH double bond CH2, this is propene, and addition of HBr into propene we will study for studying the mechanism of Markovnikov's rule. So what happens is, as you know now, HBr will be splitted as H plus and Br minus. H plus will be the electrophile, Br minus will be the nucleophile. So H plus will go and attack on the pi electrons. Now in the first case, if this carbon is used to bond with the electrophile, then what will happen? CH3, you can see CH single bond, CH3, and this carbon will be deficient and you will form this carbocation. Okay, now I will take you through the similar or second step immediately. Suppose this hydrogen goes and attaches to this carbon, then what will happen? So I'll write here CH3. If this hydrogen attaches here, you get CH2, and then this carbon will be deficient, so you'll get CH2+. So in first step you will get this carbocation, in second step you'll get this carbocation. Now look at the carbocations carefully. This carbocation, this carbon which is bearing the positive charge, is attached to two other carbon atoms, so it is a secondary carbocation. And as this positively charged carbon is attached to only one carbon, it is a primary carbocation. Now here comes in picture the stability of carbocations. You know, for such simple carbonium ions, alkyl carbonium ions, inductive effect determines the stability of carbocation. Now see, this is the positively charged carbon. It is bonded to two alkyl groups. You know, alkyl groups exhibit positive inductive effect, means they push the electrons away from them. So the electrons of this bond will be pushed away from the alkyl group towards this positively charged carbon. Similarly, this alkyl group will push the electrons towards this positively charged carbon. So the positive charge on the central carbon is more or less stabilized by the upcoming electron density from these two alkyl groups. Okay, so secondary carbocation is stable. But if you see this primary carbocation, this positive charge on the carbon is on terminal carbon. So this alkyl group will push the electrons away from it towards a positively charged carbon. But in the primary carbocation, the carbon is attached to only one other carbon. So only one alkyl group will be contributing its electrons to the nullification of positive charge on the carbocation. So secondary carbocation will be more stable than primary carbocation. Now imagine a tertiary carbocation. This is positively charged. Here there is one alkyl group, here one alkyl group, one alkyl group. Now three alkyl groups are releasing its electrons towards the positively charged carbon. So tertiary will be even more stable. So this is the order of stability for carbocations, and it is determined by the inductive effect for simple alkyl carbonium ions. Okay, so tertiary carbocation will be more stable than secondary than primary. So here in this case, here is a secondary carbocation, here is a primary carbocation. So now you must have understood that secondary carbocation is more stable. And remember that more stable a carbonium ion is, more easily it is formed. So obviously formation of this secondary carbocation is favored. So approximately 80% this carbocation is formed and approximately 20% this carbocation is formed. And now in the next step, the bromide ion will go and attack on both of these carbocations. If it is attacking on this, you will end up having CH3CHBrCH3, which is 2-bromopropane. As the carbocation, the intermediate is high in amount, obviously the formed product will be major product. So this product 2-bromopropane is found in 80% amount. It is a major product. And this primary carbocation will give you CH3CH2CH2Br, which is a minor product, which has happened in 20% amount. It is 1-bromopropane. So this is what Markovnikov's rule is. This is how it impacts the addition of unsymmetrical reagents to an unsymmetrical alkyl. I hope you have understood. I'll repeat the statement of Markovnikov's rule one more time. When an unsymmetrical reagent is added to an unsymmetrical alkyl, positive part of the reagent will go and attach with a double bonded carbon carrying greatest number of hydrogen atoms. Okay, this is applicable to unsymmetrical reagent and unsymmetrical alkenes. I hope you have understood the concept really well. If yes, hit the like button, and now don't go anywhere. We will solve 5 MCQs immediately and then I'll come back. So friends, I hope you could solve all 5 of them. And with this, it's a wrap. Let's meet in a new video with some amazing concepts and simplest of explanations. Till then, stay safe, stay blessed, and keep watching B Pharma Wise. Thank you. Bye-bye.